About 50 kilometers north of Indonesia's second largest city, Yogyakarta in central Java, is Borobudur. This is typical Javanese countryside, developed through a rice-growing civilization. The population here is almost exclusively Muslim, but they have also inherited a proud past.
This is Borobodur in Indonesia. At one time in history, Buddhism used to flourish here. That was in the 7th and the 8th centuries. So the Javanese have built the biggest ever Buddhist monument anywhere in the world, right here in Borobodur.
This amazing monument, built in homage to the Buddha by the Javanese, may have taken between 50 to 70 years to build, according to archaeologists. Today it is considered as one of the seven wonders of the world. This monument has been restored to its ancient glory through a multi-million dollar restoration project funded by UNESCO and the Indonesian government. The restoration work took 10 years to complete, between 1974 and 1983. Today, the Indonesian government has officially declared Borobudur as a dead monument, which means that it is no more used as a religious shrine. In a predominantly Muslim country, Indonesia's Buddhist population today is less than 3%. They are mainly of ethnic Chinese descent. Indonesia's Buddhists, however, see their religion as part and parcel of the country's cultural heritage.
Because Borobudur, mostly of the Indonesian know that in the ancient time, Buddhism has the deep root in Indonesia. Not only Chaitya, not only the place for puja, not only the place to strengthen our sadha, our faith to the triple gems, to the Triratna, but Borobudur is the fact, is the proof that in the ancient time our ancestor are Buddhist. And Buddhism has the deep root in Indonesia.
Borobudur has today become a major tourist attraction. Over 2 million people visit the monument each year, contributing millions of dollars to the Indonesian economy. The behavior of some visitors, however, is upsetting the Buddhists, who still consider this as a monument built in homage to the Buddha.
The foreigner visitor, although they are not Buddhists, they say that the behavior of the visitor of Borobudur is not proper. In many occasions, I try to inform to the Minister of Religious Affairs and to the other government official, but we have no power. We have no power to stop. Government consider Borobudur as the dead monuments. And government give to the Buddhist community only one day during the Vesak full moon day, Borobudur for Buddhist worship.
Each year, on the Vesak full moon day in May, Indonesia's Buddhist community turns up in force to Borobudur. Thousands gather here for the two-day festival. They coordinate and conduct most of the festivities from the Mendut Buddhist Monastery near the Borobudur Monument. This is a functioning Buddhist monastery, which is surrounded by Muslim households.
In this area, very few Buddhist followers, I think about 11 families. Most of them in this area is Muslim, but we have good neighborhood by Muslim in this area. Like on this event, where on Vaisak day, we together give and take. Our guests on Vaisak ceremony in Mendut Borobudur need sleeping, and all Muslim or Muslim family in this area gave her house for rest and sleeping during the Vesak ceremony. Buddhist follower who came to ceremony on Vesak day in the Borobudur come for many towns in Indonesia.
In Indonesia, the majority of our population is Muslim, but we don't base our rule, our law on Muslim law. So that we have to remember. So it is wrong to say, or it is not correct to say, that Indonesia is a Muslim country.
Those who flock here on Vesak Day from around Indonesia do not come only to worship. They also organize social and welfare services for the local community.
In the Vesak Day, everybody try to do something according to the Dharma, how we should learn to reduce our greed, our anger and our delusion through the practice. So what we learned, how to help others, how to make the teaching of the Buddha into practice, especially how to reduce our crave and our greed to help others, in especially in the form of the medical service for free to the poor people and food.
During the two-day medical camp, over 2,000 locals were given free health screenings and medicines. The local government health authorities cooperated with the Buddhists by providing nursing staff to work with them. The festival culminates with the procession from the Bindu temple to the Borobudur monument. The local Muslim population turn up in force to witness the colorful procession.
Once a year in Borobudur, the Theravada and the Mahayana and Tantrayana and Tridharma and Maitreya and the Japanese Buddhist called Nichiren, Soshu Indonesia, now they changed the name to Pandita Sabha. So they are also together in this association to celebrate the Vesak Day. So I think this is very special. I never seen it in other countries that all different Buddhist sects get together every year to celebrate the Vesak.